Miss Dixit.
Hi, good morning. How are you? Good, good, thank you. And yourself?
I'm doing good and I wish you a happy Independence Day.
Thank you. Wish you the same and to your entire team.
So it's the 74th Independence Day for India today. We have come so many years.
Yeah, I know. It's unbelievable. It's like, just felt like yesterday it was the 50th anniversary of our Independence Day. So, cannot believe it's already 74.
Yes, so like, years are really passing by.
Yeah, true.
So, so the reason for this session that we are having today is we want to discuss about a Made in India campaign that is going on across the country due to this pandemic. What are your views about that? So some discussions about the current scenario. Like I recall very well that when the lockdown had started in the month of March, you were the only architect way back in March who told me about the Made in India concept, that you were the first person who spoke. So during that time, did you foresee this coming, that India will take a full 360-degree turn? The Made in India campaign will be coming back, which had started way back during the Swadeshi time. Did you get a feel of that you had spoken about it?
In fact, yes. It's because by March, when we started experiencing this lockdown for the first time, I did already see that China, which had the first case of the virus, which originated from there, I knew that 2 months it was not slowing down, and I knew it is just a matter of time the rest of the world is going to be attacked by the same virus. So looking at it, my whole point is I know it is going to affect our economy. So there is going to be multiple things that is going to happen with this virus. One is economy, one is health. Third is there is going to be a social unrest, which eventually we are seeing today in terms of businesses collapsing, people losing their job. You have so many things that is happening around you, and this is going to cause a lot of disruption for India. For me, it's India first. So I knew that it's going to have a lot of disruption at that time. And I thought the best way to improvise things is to ensure your country, your economy is growing. That is where the Made in India idea came to my mind, that I think, let me contribute the smallest bit possible to ensure that my country is going to boom tomorrow. You and me, we know for a fact that everything that we are using, consuming right now during this pandemic was the best example, because we were trying to stay minimal. We were trying to avoid doing things which is not necessary. So during that time, I think it has been only an eye-opener for a lot of us to understand that we don't need so many glamorous things which are being sold to us in terms of marketing on print medium, on your television, what you keep seeing. Things are being bombarded on you.
Yes.
Okay, so exactly the way Alu Decor is today, I'm sure there are thousands of other brands. Not sure, I'm really confident about them, because I've seen them in the past, but unfortunately they are not really marketing themselves the way Alu Decor is. And I think you guys are setting a good example in the industry, where you're targeting the right audience, showcasing your product, and not bragging about that you're only made in India. Because like I told earlier, you know, I was taken aback when I got to know that you're making in India 100%, and it was such a unique product. It looks like any product that comes out from Germany or US or Japan or some other place. So that's a compliment to you guys. The funny part is, once we finished that project, we got an award, international award. And your product did enhance the balcony where I thought I should be using it. Because of course your product is an extended use product as well. And the way it was versatile in terms of the flexibility, how we could use it, I think it could do wonders to many other talented architects in India. Like you rightly said, I met your brand stall for the first time in FOID exhibition. I can still remember where your stall was, how long it took me to walk towards your stalls, all the other stalls, and I could only see these two things. And at that time itself, I decided that this is the place I'm going to be using it. How I'm going to use it, I did not know. But there was a vision, you know, where, you know, it was basically a balcony where we used it.
Mm-hmm.
And to demarcate the balcony in a nice, subtle manner, not trying to make it too loud in terms of the rest of the house interior. So that is what we wanted to do with your product. And I think it was the best fit at that time, what we thought it should be. And it had all the properties that we wanted as an external use product, which is generally very rigid. You know, you don't have the flexibility to use a lot of external grade material with so much of shapes and format that we could have done the way we thought about it. And trust me, I was elated after the whole finishing was done. And I remember, I think that time, one of the evening when I was at the client's house, even before the handover, I clicked a photograph and sent it to you to show you how amazing it looks. This pandemic has created panic in a lot of us. People, when they try to look at an antimicrobial property product compared to a normal product, and if there is going to be a price range, they're going to let go of it. The paranoia of people is going to take charge and they are going to start using such product, which has always been used in healthcare industry. So that was the place which was where it was used the most. But I think now every project is going to start demanding products like this. Like copper, this is the best example. Like copper, there are so many natural things that can be used to ensure we are protected and we are safe in a better place.
There are a lot of people around us who are saying that the pandemic has taught us this, the pandemic has taught us that, we will become like this, we will become like that. You think in the same way, people will hold on to these new values, these new principles which they have created during the pandemic with the Made in India campaign, that yes, we will continue being a Made in India country, the way Japan has done. Because every Japanese, they believed in their products. That's the reason today Japan has become an economic powerhouse. So do you think India will be able to continue like that?
I really cannot speak for the rest of our population, but yes, we are following the same system. It's a little unfortunate, I'm not being biased, but the first thing that we get information about a new product today, from the time we have seen this pandemic, and it's not only that, it's been for almost 2 or 3 years from the time we are having a political situation with our two great neighbors. Unless we don't want any product that is made in China. This has been our office motto. The second is, we are right now during this pandemic stage, we are trying to ensure as much as possible to use a product which is 100% made in India. I understand that it's not really possible. From the clothing that we are wearing to everything that we are doing today, it's unfortunate that we cannot have everything 100% made in China. So this is the reality that we are facing.
So do you also foresee that with this Made in India campaign, the economy will like also revive and the growth of the country will also start happening?
Of course, I think Made in India campaign is the whole point in doing that is to revive our economy. And when I say revive our economy, we should also start, our Prime Minister made recently one of the press release he didn't mention. It's not only about selling your product in India, start looking at exporting the same product outside, because I think there is a lot of opportunity today to market our unique products that we are making.
Things have come to a pause, which will start once again by the end of this year, because Aludecor has a lot of expansion plans.
Okay.
Yeah, great. And we are also planning a lot new more products. Like for example, during this lockdown, we launched a new product called Armor, which is an anti-insect ACP.
Wow.
Yeah, so it has a special coating called dichylamide, which will keep off insects from the area where these panels will be cladded. And the sensory systems of these insects will be affected once they come near to this panel. Seeing the 74th Independence Day of India, and we are seeing a revival of the Swadeshi campaign. So a few words from you about what all we should look forward to, how we should carry on, what is the oath that we should take? Do you think we should create it from our heart first? And then the change that we want to see in our nation, we should be the change first.
Yes, exactly.
So a few words from you on that.
Yeah. So I think most of us have understood the whole point, and understanding this pandemic is not running behind the money that we have been doing all these years. Health comes first. Your loved ones, they come first. With all the money that you have in the world, it's not going to save you if you are going to be COVID positive today. Nothing is going to save you. We have seen, it's sad, but we have seen various people, even with so much of wealth, they could not survive with this COVID. So please stop doing that. Stop running behind that money, because if you're going to start running behind that money, there are going to be other people who are going to compete with you. And that's going to create that rat race. Let's be simple, let's be nice, let's be subtle. The way we were as Indians during the time of independence. So if we follow the same motto what our forefathers had, I think life would be much happier. We all would be content. We won't run behind the latest thing that our neighbor has, and it'll create a happier nation.
Thank you so much for being a part of this show with us for Independence Day.
Yeah, it's my pleasure. It's my pleasure. And it's my pleasure that it's on Independence Day that I am doing this with you. So, Jai Hind.
Jai Hind. And once again, please take care and stay safe.
Thank you. Thank you.